Thank you all for coming. See, for me, Veerappan is a subject matter which has been haunting me since a very long time. I first heard about Veerappan somewhere in the late 90s, 97-98, when I was shooting for a film somewhere in the jungles of Mudumalai. So the fact that one person, just with a few men, can be operating from inside a forest and making the governments of two states completely go haywire in an effort to capture him fascinated me. Because without the backing of any major terror organization or a rebel state, or with great funds and resources, or without any political patronage, though the conspiracy theories could be there, but I do not believe that they exist. They actually were there in reality of supporting him. So I thought the uniqueness of a character like that was not there in the entire crime history of the world, I would think, because I can't see a parallel to Veerappan. So for a long time I wasn't clear about which aspect of Veerappan I should take to catch the spirit of the person. And at a certain time, I mean, because it's like a Mahabharata, from the time he started to the time he ended. And then I happened to meet some people who were involved in the operation of killing Veerappan. So it is the details, something I overheard, something I discussed with them, finally sparked off my interest in to tell the story of Veerappan through the point of view of the people who were somewhere involved in capturing him or killing him eventually. So when people ask me this question, how real is a film, I would say, the kind of people I met is some of the people who worked with Veerappan a long time before, who mediated between the government and Veerappan on certain specific cases and incidents. And the officers who were involved in his operations at various stages, his own wife, and primarily these will be the sources. But obviously they'll have their own versions, they'll have their own interpretations, because things change from time and from the memories and all sort of personal experiences. So to sift through that entire material and connect the dots in the most understandable format is what I attempted. And so what you're going to see in the film is that final version of what I call the truth as I know it. But even the people who were involved in parts with Veerappan, when they saw the whole film, they couldn't challenge me that this is not what it happened. Yeah, that's a thing to the credit of the research team and the overall way the screenplay has been structured. Thank you.